Bollywood producer Karim Morani surrenders before Hyderabad police after Supreme Court's order. He is facing the charge of raping a 25-year-old woman based in Delhi. Earlier, the Supreme Court had declined to grant anticipatory bail to Karim Morani and refused to interfere with Hyderabad High Court's orders. For more details on this, let's go across to Paul, who's joining in on the phone line. Paul, take us through what the developments are in this particular case.
Well, Abni, late last night at 11:45 p.m., Karim Morani, a famous producer in Bollywood, surrendered himself in front of the Hyatt Nagar police in Hyderabad. He came along with his brother, Mohammed Morani. In fact, it was earlier this year in January that several sections under which a case was booked against him for rape and wrongful confinement, as well as criminal intimidation of a 25-year-old girl in Delhi. Apparently, he repeatedly raped her and also threatened her. We're hearing that he will be produced in court today. As of now, the latest information is that he has been taken to Osmania General Hospital. It's a government hospital here in Hyderabad, where his medical examination will be done, following which he will be presented before the Rangareddy Court. The Supreme Court orders had asked him to actually surrender himself after his anticipatory bail that was given to him by the local court was struck down by the High Court. Supreme Court has also agreed that the anticipatory bail should be struck down and had ordered him to surrender himself before the Hyatt Nagar police immediately.
If you can just take us through as to when did all of this start and, you know, a little bit of the background of this entire case.
Well, what actually happened was a Delhi-based girl, 25-year-old, she lodged a complaint saying she was repeatedly raped by Karim Morani. However, Karim Morani's lawyers say that it was consensual sex and it wasn't really a rape. However, she took it to the police and filed a complaint. It happened that she was also in Hyderabad when she was sometime she was raped in Hyderabad and continued in Delhi. It went on for over a long period of time. That is why she filed the case at the Hyatt Nagar police station under which she was staying, under the limits of which she was staying when she was in Hyderabad. That is when the Hyatt Nagar police actually registered a case. It had made big news at that time in January. So under the Indian Penal Code, under Section 376, like I said before, which is rape, 342 wrongful confinement, 506 criminal intimidation, under several other sections as well, he was booked, as well as the Nirbhaya Act, which is the Criminal Law Amendment Act, he was booked. And later on, he filed for an anticipatory bail with the local court. The local court granted him. Then the High Court of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana actually struck it down. And then they moved to the Supreme Court. Supreme Court was in solidarity with what the High Court said. They were in agreement. And they said that anticipatory bail has to be struck down and he has to surrender himself before the Hyderabad police immediately. It was based on this order that came in yesterday that he flew down to Hyderabad and surrendered himself before the police.